So most Macs will have the dock at the bottom of the screen. It's there by default. And you can have it set to have it always on like this, or have it hide itself when you move away from it. I've got it set here just to be always on, and the icons are medium size. But you don't have to use the dock like this. You can customize it in a number of ways. So to customize it, one way to do it is to control click on the divider bar here. And that brings up some options, and you could turn a lot of options on or off here, or go right to dock preferences. So if you want to change something really quickly, you can do it right here without actually having to go to dock preferences. You can get to dock preferences by going to system preferences and clicking on dock as well. It takes you to the same place. So what are the things that you can customize? Well, one thing is you can change the size of the icon. So if you want to make everything much smaller, you can. You can make very tiny, and you can make them large as well. And of course, the maximum size is going to stop depending upon the number of icons you've got. So if you have a lot of icons like I do, you can't go too large. Now, if you have it very small, you can still kind of get away with trying to figure out what's there by turning magnification on and off. And you can set a maximum minimum size for magnification. What's magnification? Well, when you move the cursor over the dock, what's under the cursor will magnify. So you can still kind of pick out the icons, even if by default they're pretty small. Now, you can also position the dock somewhere else besides the bottom of the screen. So I can put it on the left side of the screen, right here. And it works the same way. Matter of fact, you could even turn on magnification and it will work the same way there. And you could position it on the right as well. And notice that you still have the divider line. Everything still works the same. It's just a vertical orientation rather than a horizontal orientation. Now another major option you have is the ability to automatically hide and show the dock. When you turn that on, and this is how I work by default, the dock will go away unless you bring your cursor down to the bottom of the screen. So interacting with the dock is the same because you have to bring your cursor down to the bottom of the screen to interact with it. The only difference is that you can't see which apps are running. So here, for instance, I see Safari is running, Finder, you know, System Preferences, ScreenFlow. They're all running, and when the dock's not there, I can't see that. Now, if you don't rely on being able to check that in the dock, then it really doesn't matter whether or not you have hide and show the dock on or off. But it is nice to have that extra screen real estate for apps. Another way you can customize the dock is to determine what happens to minimize windows. So for instance, here in TextEdit, I have three windows open. I'm going to minimize each one by hitting the yellow button. And you can see it becomes an icon on the right side of the dock. Now, I can change that so that minimizing windows goes into the application icon. This doesn't change the ones that are already there. So I could still bring these up. But now if I were to minimize them, notice that they actually go into the application icon. In other words, they just don't appear in the dock anywhere. I can control click on the application in the dock and select which one to go to, or just clicking on TextEdit itself will open up the frontmost of those. And I can use Window and TextEdit to get to them. But if you do minimize a lot of windows, it's nice to not have them all appear on the right side of the dock if that's not your intention. You can also change whether or not applications animate, meaning they bounce. When I click on Pages here, you can see it bounces up and down to launch. Now it launched pretty quickly, but sometimes applications take a long time to launch and you end up with this bouncing icon a lot. But I can turn that off and you can see Pages won't move at all. So just get rid of that piece of animation if you find it annoying. Also, you can turn on or off these little dots. See under Safari there, you've got that dot. You can turn on or off whether or not that is something that's indicated in the dock as well. We'll be right back.